This week, the Brendan LaRue story.
Brendan LaRue's story is one of dreams. As a young boy, he wanted to become a dancer, but at the age of 12, he lost his legs. Now, this would be a setback for any youngster, but not Brendan, who set his eyes on being a surgeon until, at age 14, he lost his wrists.
Without my wrists, there was nothing to keep my hands attached to my arms. So even though my hands were fine, I lost them too.
Now, Brendan may not have had as many hands and legs as the other boys, but there was one dream he didn't let go of: becoming a professional hockey player. At first, the other players treated him fairly, but after seeing all the attention that Brendan was getting, they became jealous. The special treatment stopped. Brendan toughed it out in the minors for 2 brutal years, but it all paid off when he finally got the call.
The coach said, "How would you like to be pro hockey's first legless, handless player?"
It was an inspiring night, full of inspiration. But then, 2 days later, Brendan found out that his rib cage was backwards, leaving his spine exposed, and that he needed a complete muscle transplant. The risky surgery lasted 720 hours. Brendan came back better than ever. Brendan persevered and was selected MVP. But just when it seemed like the dark clouds had finally passed, Brendan contracted scurvy, went bankrupt, and his wife was eaten by wolves. He was also molested by his Uncle Jerry. Today, Brendan's journey has opened the door for many athletes who never would have been given a chance if he hadn't broken down pro sports physical ability barrier. Athletes like Emma Heathcote, cerebral palsy sufferer and 3-time national equestrian champ. Blind stock car driver, Bobby Templeton. Deaf Olympic sprinter, Craig Connors. Gil Saarinen, the world's first professional comatose diver. And of course, Chicago shooting guard, Herbie Cohn, who was born with Judaism. Yes, none of it would have been possible without Brendan LaRue, a true inspirational portrait.